Verse 27, Martha said to Jesus, "Yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Messiah, the Son of God, who is come into the world." Martha believed. She's clearly a believer. So how does she handle the fact that her brother has just died? Well, if you looked at verse number 21, Lord, Martha said to Jesus, "If you had been here, my brother would not have died. But I know that even now, God will give you whatever you ask." In other words, Martha is saying, "I still believe, Lord, you're powerful enough and you're good enough to have stopped my brother from dying. But it leaves me with the question. It leaves me with the mystery of why you didn't. In fact, it leaves me asking, why did he get sick in the first place? And also, I don't understand, Lord, why you didn't come sooner. Or if you could come sooner, then why didn't you just heal him at a distance, as you've done for others? I don't understand why." That's what the Christian often has to say in the face of suffering. Why? 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 Why is this? Why is that? Because we don't have all the answers. But we do still have hope. We believe in God because of Jesus. And Jesus is loving. He came to die for us on the cross for our forgiveness. And we believe he's powerful because he rose from the dead and he went back into heaven to be in control of everything. And the fact of suffering doesn't change these truths that we know about God because of Jesus. It sits alongside them. And yes, we oftentimes feel perhaps the tension of that. And we're often left saying, "I still believe you're loving and you're powerful, but I don't understand why." But in our suffering, we have hope because we believe in God because of Jesus.